What's up, everyone? Sam here from ByteByByte.com, and in this video, I want to show you how to develop a coding interview prep plan for the holidays so that you know exactly what you need to focus on and so that you actually can stick to that plan. And if you're interested in tons more videos to help you nail your coding interview and land that dream FAANG job, make sure that you hit the subscribe button and the notification bell if you haven't already, and you'll get notified every week when we release new videos. I don't know about you, but for me, every year, the holiday season is kind of a double-edged sword. Because on the one side, I actually have all this time off from work, right? I'm not gonna be going into the office, I'm not gonna be working on all the stuff that I'm normally working on, and so it's this big block of free time that I have where I'm like, hey, I could actually use this to accomplish something, like studying for my coding interviews. But on the flip side, it also tends to be time that I'm spending with family, and it tends to be time where there's a lot going on, and so it can be hard to use that time as effectively as I want to. And in this video, I really want to help you break down how to create a plan for the holidays so that you're going to be able to use that time that you have off work as effectively as possible without sacrificing everything and without, like, you know, not spending any time with your family. So I'm going to give you two specific tips that you can use to prepare for your interviews over the holidays. Tip number one is to not overcommit. And this is so, so important. And this is true for studying in general, where I see people are preparing for their interviews and they're like, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do this. And they just make this ridiculous plan that they can't possibly stick to. And so maybe they stick to it for a day or they stick to it for 2 days, but by the third day, they're already sort of falling off the plan, and then it gets demoralizing because you're not succeeding at your plan, and it becomes this like vicious spiral where you basically then completely fail to stick to anything that you intended to. And so it's so important with the holidays, especially with everything going on, that you don't overcommit. The idea is you want to commit to doing a small amount every day or every other day, and also make a flexible plan that's going to allow you to say, hey, I didn't have time today, but I do have time this other time, and so I'm just going to go and work around what is already going on. So if your family wants to go out to dinner or your friends invite you to a holiday party, you can still go do that and not feel bad like you're missing out on a major part of your studying. And the key here, the biggest key with not overcommitting and not trying to do too much over the holidays, is to plan ahead. So I want you to think about this. When you go to study, how much time are you actually spending thinking about what am I going to study versus actually doing the studying itself? Right? A lot of times we spend so much time actually just thinking about what the heck are we going to study that it takes like the first 30 minutes and then we're tired and we don't actually want to study. And so it can be really, really valuable, and I highly encourage you to do this. Plan before the holidays, what are the specific things that you want to study? What are the topics? What are the algorithms you want to learn? What are the specific problems you want to solve? And then you can just go in and go down the list. So anytime you find free time over the holidays, anytime you have 30 minutes, you just go and pull the next item off of your list of things that you want to do over the holidays, and you can just check off items. You don't need to think about, oh, am I focusing on the right things? Is this what I actually want to be studying? You'll be able to just jump in and quickly use those little bits of free time that you have throughout the holidays. And that way you're not trying to say like, well, I need to find a block of 2 hours every day to study. You're able to just quickly pull out, you know, what is the next thing, spend 15 minutes, spend 30 minutes studying. And that's a great way to make sure that you're actually getting stuff done and that you're not overcommitting and trying to do like everything in this really busy time of year. Now, before we go on, I want you to take a second and comment below, what is the number one most important thing that you want to learn over the holidays? I'm really curious to hear what you're going to be focusing on this year. Step number two that's super, super important for the holidays is learning how to deal with distractions. Right? You're going to be dealing with distractions both from your family and from work for the entire holidays. And it's so important that you have a specific plan that you're going to follow to make sure that you're able to deal with these distractions. So I want to give you a couple specific tips, both for your personal and for your work, on how to deal with these distractions and how to make sure that you're actually getting done the stuff that you need to do. So the first and most important thing you need to do is learn how to say no. This applies in both cases. This applies to work and this applies to your family. So in the case of work, people might try and ask you to do work over the holidays, or your boss might say, hey, can you like take home this work to do? And you have to get into the mindset of, if you are taking your time off, I know this isn't always possible, but to the greatest extent you possibly can, you want to resist agreeing to take on anything that you don't absolutely have to. Of course, there are going to be cases where your job depends on it, but unless your job actually depends on it, don't volunteer to do any work over the holidays. Don't volunteer to do any work during your time off unless you absolutely have to. And the same is true with family stuff or with stuff with your friends. You get so many invitations to holiday parties, to go out to a movie, to hang out with your friends, and what you have to do is you have to prioritize. Right? I'm not saying you can't do anything and you shouldn't enjoy yourself over the holidays, but at the same time, you're not going to be able to do everything all the time and also accomplish your goals. So you have to get used to saying no to the things that are not a high priority to you and saying yes to the things that are a high priority. So maybe you pick and choose and you say, okay, this holiday party has the most of my friends going to it, and so I'm gonna go to that so I can get the biggest bang for my buck and see as many people at one time as I can, but I'm not gonna go to this other thing, and I'm not gonna hang out with this person individually because we'll get to see each other another time. So saying no is super, super important. In addition to saying no, another thing that's really, really important is setting clear boundaries. And this, for work, turning on an autoresponder is the greatest way to immediately set a boundary. Turn on an autoresponder so anytime anyone emails you, they get an email saying, hey, I'm out of the office until X date. I will get back to you when I get back into the office. Such an easy tactic, but it tells people very clearly, I'm not checking my email. Don't expect something back from me. And along those lines, don't respond to people. Like, don't plan to actually respond to people unless there's something that's critical. Again, if your job depends on it or if, you know, the entire system breaks down and you need to fix it, that's one thing. But unless it's absolutely critical, do not respond to this. And to set clear boundaries with your family, it's critical that you actually talk to people. Because I think that a lot of times we assume that everyone knows what's going on with us, but we don't actually tell them, right? So with your family, a lot of times, and with your friends too, they may not realize that you have this goal and that you have this thing that you need to accomplish over the holidays. And so you need to actually tell them, here is what I'm doing. And so I might be busy. You can explain to them that you're going to need a little bit of space and you're going to need a little bit of time and you might need to sit some things out so that you can accomplish this other goal. And you can plan ahead, that way people won't disturb you, and plan ahead, like, where can you find a quiet space? Where are you going to be able to find time? Maybe that means that, you know, you go to the library for an hour. Or maybe that means that you wake up a little bit early and you do some work before everyone gets up. There are a lot of ways to like get away from these distractions and sort of set those boundaries, but you have to be proactive about doing it. And I think that's really, if I could summarize this all in a nutshell, being proactive about finding space and about making time for your interview prep over the holidays is the single most important thing you can do. So that's all I got for you today. If you're looking for something specific to focus on over the holidays, I'd highly encourage you to check out our free 50 coding interview questions guide, where we go through 50 of the most common questions that you might be asked in your interview. This is going to be a great place for you to start if you're not sure what to focus on, and you can literally just go through the guide question by question, and it'll be a great starting point and a great place for you to practice. And if you haven't already, make sure that you hit the like and subscribe button on this video. Share it. If you got value out of this video, I would really, really appreciate it. And I'd encourage you to check out, there should be a couple other videos around here. Encourage you to check those out as well. And I look forward to seeing you in the next video.